Kronzler, USA. Pressure washer perfection.
All right, everybody. So this is the original Josh back again with Kronzler USA, pressure washer perfection. So you've found that the symptom that you're trying to solve with your Kronzler pressure washer is loss of pressure. So the first thing to identify is what type of pressure loss are you experiencing? We can experience pressure loss in a number of different ways with pressure washers. And they can be caused by all sorts of factors. As it pertains to the pump, whenever we have pressure loss that, let's start with complete pressure loss. So we pull the trigger, just a little stream of water coming out of the nozzle, no measurable pressure on the gauge, open and close, no change whatsoever. That symptom is going to point us towards the unloader valve and the subcomponent of the unloader valve, which is the easy start valve or bypass valve. So our next type of pressure loss that we're going to discuss is pulsation pressure loss. So typically with pulsation pressure loss, we're going to see about half of the output lost on the gauge. We will also notice that with this pulsation, it's going to be like the massage setting on a shower head. It's going to be very rhythmic and persistent. Open and close the gun jet, still same symptom both instances, but it's going to give you that machine gun brrrr type of pulsation with, like I said, about 50% loss in pressure. That is going to point towards our check valves. In your pressure washer pump, you have a total of 6 check valves. For each plunger, there's an intake valve and a discharge valve. The condition that will cause the pulsation is most often that one of the check valves will be obstructed or damaged in some way that is causing it to, causing water to stop for one check valve, but not for the other. So the water is able to kind of go back and forth where it's only supposed to be moving in one direction. And that's what results in our pressure loss. And one more thing about pulsation pressure loss. Very easy to notice with pulsation pressure loss. Where your gauge normally will read and have the needle stay relatively still on the pressure rating when you're squeezing the trigger. Pulsation pressure loss, you're gonna see that needle jumping back and forth. So if you see that, we know that it's the check valves. So our third type of pressure loss that we wanna go over is cavitation pressure loss. This isn't something that's gonna necessarily require is not going to be solved by servicing the pump, but cavitation pressure loss is going to present itself in most commonly you pull the trigger, you get your burst of pressure, which seems like it's at its normal output, and then it's going to somewhat flutter down, maybe you start to build back up a little bit, drop back out. Very inconsistent, there won't usually be any pattern to it whatsoever. That is, like I said, most likely due to cavitation on a force-fed system where you have this hooked up to your garden hose supply at your house. If it's happening then it is most likely some sort of restriction or introduction of air or turbulence into the water flow going to the pump. So that can result in failure of certain components in the pump, but that's not necessarily going to immediately require service on the pressure washer pump to correct it. You have to actually correct your water supply for that part. Now, cavitation can be recognized when you see symptoms on your O-rings. You will notice that the O-rings look like they've been chewed by a mouse. Little nicks taken out of them. Sometimes the O-ring will actually start to peel because the check valves are being forced into the seated position so hard that it's damaging the check valve O-rings. It will also cause the O-rings to become somewhat boxed in shape. They won't look round, like a round cross section as they are when they're new. So that's more so something that you should be aware of from the aspect of how to tell that it was cavitation that caused the failure of the pump. So the last part of cavitation related pressure loss is related to if you are feeding the pressure washer from a tank. So these pumps are self-priming and can draw water to themselves. However, in the instance that the seals have enough hours on them or poor operating conditions have caused the seals to fail prematurely, the pump starts to struggle at trying to pull water to itself. So in those instances, you will start to experience that intermittent cavitation-like pressure loss, like I described before, where pull the trigger, burst the pressure, kind of dips out, maybe just a little stream coming out the nozzle. You can typically confirm this by hooking your pressure washer up to a forced water supply, in which case you'll find that it almost begins to operate like perfect conditions. So that would be the case where if there it has been enough wear and tear on the pump to necessitate seal replacement, or if some sort of poor operating conditions have caused the pump to age more quickly, then water seals may be necessary for correcting that particular issue. Now, we've talked about the three types of pressure loss that are commonly resultant of breakdown of the pressure washer pump, but it's important to point out something to always consider is your accessories. Do you have a clogged nozzle? You know, is the spray coming out of the nozzle in sort of a weird pattern? If so, maybe you aren't actually experiencing pressure loss, but only allowing a small amount of water to exit the nozzle and thereby making the pressure washer think that it's not actually spraying. There's also conditions that can trick you into thinking you're having pressure loss, where if you have the Vario nozzle in the low pressure position, you're not supposed to get high pressure. You're not forcing it through a high pressure nozzle. So make sure, like I said, to use your Krenzla accessories when the application, when it fits your particular conditions. And if you are using a 1322 and don't have Krenzla accessories, make sure that you're using brand new accessories or ones that you know are in good operating condition in order to diagnose your machine. So there you go. Those are our three primary types of pressure loss that involve servicing the pump. We have complete pressure loss, pulsation pressure loss, and cavitation pressure loss. So go ahead and jump to the next section of the video. You'll find those details in the description below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. It's the original Josh with Krenzla USA, pressure washer perfection.
Krenzla USA, pressure washer perfection.